Hey everybody, it's Premier Gal here, and welcome to the final video of the three-part Digital Anarchy Transcriptive video series. In this series, you've learned how to use Transcriptive to auto-transcribe video interviews and videos inside of your timeline. And in the second part of the series, you learned how you can use Transcriptive to ultimately edit faster and improve and optimize your workflow. And in this video, you're going to learn how you can use Transcriptive to actually get your video more views by enhancing the SEO through captions. So before we dive in, I just want to remind you, if you want to get a two-week free trial, just email sales@digitalanarchy.com. All right, so let's go ahead and dive in. I'm going to show you how to up your SEO game. In my timeline here, I have a video I already posted on social media and YouTube about me going freelance, and I want to add captions to them. So rather than transcribe the full video by hand, I use Transcriptive in Premiere Pro to automatically create a transcript. Now all I have to do is click on export as a .srt file and save it to my local drive. Now on the YouTube video settings, I will click on subtitles CC menu and select add new subtitles or closed captions. Here I can select the language and choose upload a file. From here, I'll select subtitles file and choose the .srt file from my local hard drive. So once the .srt file is uploaded to your YouTube video, that becomes part of the metadata of the video that's included in Google's search engine. So all the words are part of Google's search. In addition to all the keywords that you add manually to your video's metadata, all the text from the transcript is now searchable. What this does is improve your search engine optimization, meaning that if people are searching for particular types of things online and it's related to your content, your video will appear in that search when they search for those keywords. You can also do the same for Facebook as well. Simply click on Edit Video, then under Captions, choose Upload SRT File and hit Save. Not only will this make your video accessible, adding captions to your video can also improve your viewership. Most of the time, people watch Facebook videos with the sound turned off, so including captions benefits your viewership. Lastly, let's say you want to burn the captions into the video itself. Back in Premiere Pro, simply import the closed captioning file, the .srt, into your project panel. Then drag and drop the file on top of your video in the sequence. Then you can reposition the captions using the effects controls. And if you want, you can also change some stylization, such as the color in the font, using the captioning panel. Then when you go up to File to export your video, from the Export Settings window, just select the Captions tab and make sure that the Burn Captions into your video is selected. This is a very popular way to do captions for Facebook video, as the user does not have the choice to turn them on or off, they are always there. So that concludes our three-part video series on Transcriptive. I hope that it shed light on some of the useful tools that it could give you to ultimately improve your workflow and improve the way that your video is viewed and shared online. If you have any further questions about Transcriptive, please don't hesitate to leave a comment below. Also, if you guys want to subscribe to my channel, just go ahead and hit that button right over there and it will notify you when I make new video productions every week. And down there, you can click on that button to head over to patreon.com to leave me a monthly tip to help me make more videos like this on my channel. And down there, you can click on the next button to learn something new. Thanks again. Bye.